Trend trading is a trading style that focuses on trading in the direction of the trend, trying to catch the big moves in the market. Trend trading strategies assume that the market will continue to move in the direction of the trend and try to profit from it. It is usually used in medium to larger timeframes, where trades can be held for several days. However, entering a trade on a single time frame can be problematic. This is because the trend in a higher time frame can move in the opposite direction. For this reason, analysis with multiple timeframes is important. There are many different approaches to building a trend trading strategy, either using indicators or price action methods. In this video, I would like to show you a strategy that uses a multi-timeframe analysis with the Supertrend. So let's put together a strategy, code it in Pine Script, and test it automatically. What's up, trading nerds, and welcome back to a new video. The Supertrend is a trend following indicator and is used to determine the trend of the market. It relies on the average of the high and low of the candle and the volatility that is measured by the ATR, the average true range. The Supertrend indicator has two inputs, a period and a multiplier. Both inputs are used in the calculation of the ATR. In the strategy, we will use two Supertrend indicators, one from the current time frame and another from a higher time frame. The main trend is determined by the higher time frame Supertrend, so we will look only for long trades when the higher time frame Supertrend is green and only look for short trades when it is red. As an entry signal, we will use a trend change of a lower time frame Supertrend. We will enter a long trade if the Supertrend turns green and short trade if it turns red, but only if it's corresponding with a higher time frame Supertrend. For the exit strategy, we won't use a take profit target, but a trailing stop loss. This gives us the opportunity for big profit trades and hopefully cut losses quickly. As the trailing stop loss price, we will use the lower time frame Supertrend. You can make many adjustments in the coded trading script. You can change the Supertrend period and factors in both timeframes individually to optimize them for your markets. The current time frame is always the time frame you are looking at, so in this example it is a 30-minute time frame. The higher time frame can be changed via the input. You can also enable to enter a trade when the higher time frame Supertrend is changing, but these signals are often very late, because a trend change on the higher time frame requires often already a big move. After that, the market will most likely make a pullback. This means most times you will get stopped out, so it's better to enter after the pullback at the next Supertrend signal. You can also add an ADX filter to filter out ranging markets, and even add a take profit strategy if you want to. You can check it out for free and backtest your favorite markets and timeframes. I will leave a link in the video description, or just search for MTF Supertrend Trading Nerd on TradingView. If you like this type of content, please like the video for the YouTube algorithm and subscribe to the channel. And now let's have a look at some backtesting results. For these backtests, I used the 30-minute chart, and for the higher time frame, I chose 4-hour candles. I also used 1% risk per trade and compound interest. Fees and slippage are not taken into account. At the Apple stock, the strategy made 55% profit over 256 trades. Profit graph is rising with some bigger drawdowns. On BTC USD, the strategy made nice profit at the beginning, this then slowed down, and currently it's at a drawdown. Over 287 trades, it made 76% profit. And finally, the graph for GBP JPY, the strategy made their 50% profit over 211 trades. For the first 100 trades, it were around break even, but then had a really nice winning streak. The profit factors for all three markets were around 1.5. The maximum drawdown was on Apple at around 12%. The win rate for all three markets were around 40%. It's important to mention that a profitable trade does not necessarily mean a high profit. Due to the trading stop, a trade can also be a very small profit or a loss. The highest Sharpe ratio was achieved on BTC USD with close to 0.6. If you are interested in other trading strategies and free trading scripts, check out my other videos on the channel.